Well, in a matter of hours, our Prime Minister Anthony Albanese will come face to face with the Chinese president for an historic meeting. Charles Croucher is travelling with him and joins us now from Beijing. Charles, good morning to you. Obviously, trade sanctions are heavy on the agenda. They'll dominate discussions. It's all very tricky and layered, is it not?
It is very tricky, Carl. It's a very cold morning here in Beijing, which is an unusual environment for a thawing of diplomatic relationships. But it seems that's what's happening. There is some good news on the horizon for Australian producers, particularly those that work in wine, in beef, and in crayfish. We make some of the best wine, best beef, and best crayfish in the world. And it seems those final tariffs imposed by the Chinese on Australia over the last three or four years are about to be lifted. That may happen before Christmas. That's $1 billion industries that will improve their output, sends their products to Australia, and more importantly, of course, improves job prospects in Australia. And that's what the Prime Minister is here. That was what yesterday was all about in Shanghai. Very much that was for show. Today is for dough, because he sits down with the Chinese leader Xi Jinping. We know the history here between Xi Jinping and Australia over the last 10 years. It's gone from effectively this powerhouse relationship that's funded so much of Australia's development through iron ore and through our exports to the real frost that came over in the wake of sort of 2020, the COVID inquiry that the Morrison government called for, Australia standing up to China when it came to some of those trade sanctions. And now we have this very different China heading in what seems like a very different path. And that's what sets the stage for today's meeting, which, given those trade sanctions were kind of sorted yesterday, will now become about the future. And it's a future that will really define our region in so many ways, and also in a lot of ways, prosperity in the region as well.
Okay, the Trans-Pacific Trade Agreement, I think China wants to be part of, brings all kinds of ramifications though, doesn't it? I can't imagine an ally like Japan would be very cool with China joining.
Not cool at all with it, Carl. China wants to get on board this Trans-Pacific Partnership. It is a multilateral. Many countries around the Pacific and even the UK want in, have a trade agreement. It's worth, well, the Australia-China agreement's worth sort of billions, and indeed multiple billions, hundreds of billions. The Trans-Pacific Partnership is worth trillions, so we're playing in a whole different ballgame. To get in, which is what China wants, and in some ways what China needs at the moment, they have to have the agreements of all those that are currently involved. You're right, no way Japan does it. I doubt Vietnam will do it, and it seems unlikely that Canada would get on board as well. But what Australia can do is facilitate some kind of improvement in the way China conducts its trade, because that is the biggest problem we've seen in Australia, with all those billions of dollars worth of trade sanctions. And there's a possibility that somewhere down the track, China may become part of it. That will be the big question from Xi Jinping. Anthony Albanese went into this saying he will be frank, he will be forthright with his Chinese counterpart, knowing that, as I said, this is a different China, the one we've seen in the last 4 or 5 years. This also coincides, Carl, this trip, a note, the 50th anniversary of Gough Whitlam coming to China. He was the first Prime Minister to do so back in 1973. On that occasion, Australia gave the Chinese a prized Murray bull. This time, no bull, we're told, but let's hope that's in more ways than one.
Good on you, Charlie. Great way to end it. Appreciate it, Sarah. Welcome back to the show. Well, Anthony Albanese will today meet Xi Jinping face-to-face in Beijing.
It's been almost 7 years since the last Australian Prime Minister made a trip to China, and 50 years since Gough Whitlam's visit, first historic visit. Senior analyst at the Australian Strategic Policy Institute, Malcolm Davis, joins us now from Canberra. Malcolm, good morning. This is a pretty significant meeting.
It certainly is. As you say, this is the first meeting between an Australian Prime Minister and a Chinese leader in 7 years. And, you know, on the 50th anniversary of Gough Whitlam's visit, I think it's highly significant. But we shouldn't get our hopes up that this somehow leads to a reset and we're back in the sort of period of 2012, 2014. I think there's a lot of challenges in the relationship and big strategic risks ahead. And what this visit does, I think, is potentially open up some more opportunities for trade, but it doesn't do much more than that.
Okay, so there's we need to be realistic here. There's only so much we'll be able to achieve.
Absolutely. This visit is not going to dissuade the Chinese from using military force against Taiwan or in the South China Sea. This visit is not going to see China cease interfering in our domestic situation in terms of trying to steal intellectual property or interfere in electoral processes or harass ethnic Chinese populations in Australia. So, you know, whilst this is good for trade and everyone needs to trade, let's not see too much more than that in this visit.
I mean, there is a lot to get through, all of which you mentioned just there. I guess trade is one of the key focuses for this trip. We've seen the end of some sanctions, but not all of them. Are you optimistic we might see more off the back of this?
We might, but I don't necessarily see sanctions as the most important thing. You've got an Australian citizen in a Chinese prison held without charge, and he's been sitting there for a number of years. That is the most important issue that I think the Prime Minister should be addressing. And then you've got all these other big strategic issues, which I understand the Prime Minister is not going to raise Taiwan with President Xi. But nevertheless, it doesn't address those key issues. And at the end of the day, if in spite of all the trade and all the engagement, China does use military force against Taiwan in the second half of this decade, then that trade grinds to a halt. We are not going to be trading with China if they use force against Taiwan.
It's also very delicate, Malcolm, with our other allies in the region who have been very loyal. China's pushing to become a member of the Trans-Pacific Trade Pact. I mean, how does Tokyo view all of this?
Look, I think we should be very cautious about allowing China into that because once in, you can't get them out, and they will then use that arrangement, that organisation, to dominate commerce and trade in the region. And so we have to be cautious about China's ulterior motives. You know, a few years ago, China was very much of a wolf warrior type approach of threatening and coercing, and they still do that to a certain degree with some states, like the Philippines, for example. But for us, they are now taking a more softly approach. So they've changed their tactics, but their strategic ambitions have not changed. And I think that is what we have to keep uppermost in our minds.
Interesting. Really good to talk to you, Malcolm. Thank you so much. The Prime Minister is in China today, quote, for very positive, long-standing trade tariffs talks on Australia's produce that could soon come to an end. Nine's political editor Charles Croucher is in Shanghai with the story.
It is a day in many ways 7 years in the making. Anthony Albanese will tonight meet with Xi Jinping here in the Chinese capital. During a 24-hour stop in Shanghai, the Prime Minister helped showcase Australian produce at the world's largest import expo. Among more than 250 Australian exhibitors were crayfish and beef producers. These are both products still attracting tariffs here in China, although there is a real confidence this morning that the last remaining sanctions will be gone in the next few months.
What he can expect from me is a continuation of the patient, calibrated and deliberate way of engaging. And what I expect from President Xi is the same.
And today, at the Great Hall of the People, the Prime Minister and the President. Anthony Albanese vowing to be frank and forthright with the Chinese leader, but conscious that what happens here tonight will impact jobs in Australia, the price of goods in Australia, and even as far as peace in our region.